listen closely, not for very much longer. I've got to keep control. To the left, then step to the right. Put your hands on your hips and bring your knees inside. Well, it's a pelvic thrust that really drives you insane. Let's do the time warp again. Let's do the time warp again. It's so dreamy. No, you can't see me. No, not at all. In another dimension, with voyeuristic intention. Well secluded, I see all. With a bit of a mind flip, you're into the time slip. And nothing can ever be the same. You've been starting sensation, like you're under sedation. Let's do the time warp again. Let's do the time warp again. It's just a jump to the left. 8-20-4. Then step to the right. Put your hands on your hips. And bring your knees inside.
The next song.
Well, yeah.
Welcome everybody to Danni Tjokko Happy Family Fun Time Power Jam Band, episode 60, the last episode.
Woo, last episode! Welcome everyone!
Oh, it's so nice.
Yeah, we kicked this off with another song of that very child unfriendly movie slash musical, The Rocky Horror Picture Show. Ah!
How are you feeling about the last episode?
Yeah, it's. We've come a long way, man. Remember the first video we did? We were just gonna make one video.
Yeah, I was just
on your phone. You were just playing some songs and you're like, hey, can you record this? And then you posted it. Mm-hmm. And then someone was like, hey, how about 30 of these?
Yeah. And then we challenged ourselves to do 30 more.
Yeah, exactly. And then we started editing with the 30 extra.
So what do you think you've learned through this process? we have had a lot of like technical issues, like
growing pains,
editing issues, converting files
issues.
So we can use our files. Yeah, we got into some trouble on the way.
Yeah,
learned the editing program. Is it Dr. Olsen?
I'm not sure.
No, it's my phone.
It's your phone. Hello.
Okay, we're gonna have a short break here. We have to go to the hospital to meet Dr. Olsen. We were gonna try to do the whole episode before.
We'll be back. We're back.
We're back from the hospital.
We bought ourselves a little treat. There's a Starbucks in the hospital. And we haven't had a coffee in a very long time. We used to have coffee all the time when we were here in Pittsburgh. And
I gave up drinking coffee 1 year ago. Took me 1.5 months.
Yeah.
Right. I had withdrawal for at least 6 weeks or something.
For a long time.
I had headache for 1.5 months. I never eaten so much painkillers.
Yeah.
It was horrible withdrawal.
It was horrible for everybody involved. It wasn't pleasant to live with that.
Yeah,
either.
I was like when Lindy was pregnant, you know. I think we evened it out there.
We evened out the playing field.
So this is cafe latte, but it's decaf.
Okay, let's do a quick recap on what happened in the hospital. Dr. Olsen came in. He did a
ultrasound
on Willow's eye, and they saw that the retina is nice and flat.
And so attached.
And attached. So that surgery was a success.
Total success.
Dr. Nishal also came in. The pressure was 15 in the OR, which is normal. Everything looks good. We just need to wait and see what happens next.
They're talking about up to 4 months.
So we need to leave the oil in for 2 months. Is what Dr. Nishal just told us.
Under observation once a week.
Yeah.
Something like that, once, twice a week.
So we are definitely here for 4 more months. Dr. Nishal very graciously offered to go out, to take us out for a coffee for feeling depressed. How sweet.
Yeah.
He's worried that we're, you know, worrying or whatever. That's really nice. But we're not.
We're not.
We just go with it and we'll see what happens. Like, I've never heard him talk like this, but he said we need a bit of luck for Willow's eye to
come back or
to, yeah,
or just for her to have a vision.
Yeah.
Because there's a lot of scar tissue in there. But this is the situation now, and we just live with it. This is just the way it is, and there's nothing we can do about it. We just put our trust in the best doctors that are here, and I mean, they have fixed so many eyes that, you know, Dr. Nishal has, I don't know how many kids he has given vision.
Yeah,
but
a lot. Many, many, many kids.
Yeah.
Before we go any further, let's go and say happy birthday to whoever has a birthday.
Okay.
Shall we?
Yo. Dora Gudrun.
Nay. Dóra, happy birthday!
Árni, she's a singer that I played with in Eiríkur's sister's wedding.
Righto.
Okay.
Your auntie's wedding.
kind of. And Sandra Gumus, Breiðholt represent Hólabergsskúli.
Happy birthday, all of you.
Happy birthday.
Enjoy, man. Hey, what a privilege is it to have a birthday on our celebration episode. Wow.
Exactly. We're going wild with coffee and everything.
Yeah, we're going all in, guys. We're partying hard. Back to our celebration episode.
Yeah.
So we were talking about how the things we learned.
Yeah, through this.
Throughout the 60 days of video making.
Yeah, I mean, you learned a bit of editing.
Yeah, like I'm learning more tricks every time.
I like your effect with the gula beat when you get 1 point.
That's a Super Mario Bros. Sound.
Yeah.
I thought it was fun to put that in.
Yeah, it's good.
And I like that one also. What is your favorite, like, edit that we've done so far?
Favorite edit? Well, I like it every now and then you do like a close-up when we do like stupid facial expressions.
Like when you said my food was delicious.
Yeah. For example, you know.
Look, here's the thing. Here's what I would like to know. If you have a favorite episode or a favorite clip that we showed or whatever, let me know. I like to know things like this. A while ago, we talked to a friend of ours, Christine, and she said her favorite episode was the one where we wanted to go on the swing and the swings were canceled in the park. She liked that one. And I would like to know. If you want to leave a comment, that would be cool. We have learned to tick all the boxes before we start filming, is the card in the camera, is the battery full, is the amp on?
Oh yes.
Stuff like that.
Yeah, I've started playing the guitar and oh, we don't have the amp on.
We just try to improve every day or learn new things and...
Should I maybe do a shot on my cell phone so people can see our view?
What, our messy room?
Yeah. No, this is what we're working in. But they always just see this, you know, except when we have a shot from the kitchen or Willow's doing something.
Our messy kitchen.
Yeah, I'm gonna get my phone.
Before we started the episodes where we were editing, we were talking about, oh yeah, then we can film in the kitchen and we can film here. And our general conclusion was that, okay, if we're gonna do that, then we just need to keep our apartment clean more often and, you know.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And we have never cleaned up, especially because before we start a video. Because a lot of the times our filmmaking is very spontaneous, like, oh, someone is cooking or Willow is doing something and we just very spontaneously grab the camera and then we start filming. A lot of it is unplanned, but...
Yeah, it's not like we have a script.
Exactly.
It's mostly, okay, let's talk about this, or... Like now we decided to talk about what we learned in the editing process.
Yeah.
I've learned to EQ.
Yeah.
And I learned to clean up sounds. He's probably not in the picture anymore. In
her
the frame.
Her butt probably is.
But I'm not very happy with the sound, that I like the effects and... There's always something wrong.
We just need to fine tune more.
I need to figure that better out.
Here's the good news though. We bought a lot of new gadgets and we're gonna play with them until we have everything right. I'm not saying it will be tomorrow or next week or the next month or whenever, but slowly and steady, we will get there.
Yeah. Lindy has a project that she has been working on.
I have many projects though.
Yeah, one of her projects is this thing here. Coming up exclusively.
Well, my man.
Well.
What is up here?
I am working on one of my projects. This project is a tactile book I am making for Willow. Because of her limited vision, it's really good for her if she has things she can touch and feel. And this little project, I call it the Book of Eyes. And I got a bunch of wiggly eyes here. And every page on this book has wiggly eyes on it. This is a snail I made. Here's a worm. These little balls here were made by my mom. And these are your socks.
Oh.
Yeah. My mom also made this.
My old socks that had
your old
that
socks.
Hole in it.
Yeah.
Here's where the man clown. Can see it all.
And this guy. I only just started this one today. Working with these little pasta pieces was actually an idea from my mom. And I'm gonna just do it like this. And for the longest time, like, I thought it was a great idea to use these little pastas. But for the longest time, I had no idea how I would incorporate it into the Book of Eyes. Mm-hmm. Because I wanted something with a face on it, and I had no idea what to do with the pasta. I joined an art exposition last week, and I was just flipping through all the other artworks that were submitted, and I found this one piece where someone had used these bits as someone's hair. And I thought, that's it. That's what I need to do.
Is this Rasta hair?
The original artwork was, yeah, it was really well done. And here is another book that I did. This is the very first one I made. And it's just so much fun to make. This is one of Willow's favorite pages. She loves this one. She always keeps coming back to it.
So these are like pearls?
Yeah, these are just beads on a string. And this is like a sort of velvet tape that I found. These are more eyes. And my mom also made this guy. And this is just some random stuff. I got these blank books from Ranveig. Ranveig is a coordinator, counselor for the blind. How do you call that?
Yeah, something like that. She's
the blind organization.
Like our social worker?
Or yes, sort of. Kind of. So she helps Willow because she works with a lot of blind people. And yeah, she just gives us ideas and this and that. And I have another book that I brought here to Pittsburgh, and I already have a lot of ideas for that one too. So, oof, I got plenty of stuff to do.
Great.
I'm gonna get back to it.
And Willow's waking up.
Willow's waking up. You gotta go. Two things about that clip. First of all, I want to thank my mom for sharing ideas. And my mom has also been doing some crochet work for other things that were in the book, like little sheep. Sheep balls, I was gonna say, the balls to make the sheep.
The sheep balls?
That's better, yeah.
Yeah, I think people eat sheep
balls. Merci, mama, for the help. And, yep, that's it. And the second thing, did you see how long Ranveig's title is? Let me read it back, okay? Usually when we talk about Ranveig, we have no clue what to call her, like counselor or social worker or whatever. When she sends us an email, here's what it says. Special Educational Advisor and Orientation and Mobility Specialist.
Wow.
That's one heck of a title. It's Sirkensluraugjavi og Umferliskennari. And she works for the National Institute for the Blind, Visually Impaired and Deafblind. And now I'm going to butcher Icelandic again. Þjónustu og þekk. Gingar miðstöð fyrir blinda, sjónskerta og einstaklinga með samþætta sjón og heyrnarskerðingu. How was that?
It was good.
That
was
good.
Thanks.
Yeah.
But so imagine that's the title of an institution.
I mean, exactly.
What are we supposed to call this?
Yeah, is there like a short version you can say?
I just say the blind.
Yeah,
the blind center.
Exactly, but then their website is just like www.midstuth.is.
Yeah, Midstuth.
So can we just say, oh, we're going to Midstuth?
Yeah. Are we going to do an announcement on the, what are we going to do with the, are we going to continue the episodes or?
Okay, here's what we're gonna do. We will continue making episodes, but we will not do them every day anymore. We just want to take more time to bring better quality and to practice more and to make it as good as we can. And then we don't have to rush the editing. If there's something like bad Wi-Fi or bad connection, then it's not such a big deal anymore. And then we can at least upload them every day or every time at a specific day and time so that it's more consistent. And we're gonna do an episode every Friday at 3 p.m. our time.
Yeah, that's 7 in Iceland, 9 in Belgium.
Yes. And 2 a.m. I think in Thailand.
So we have 3 days to make the next episode.
Exactly.
I had an idea last night. We were listening to 100 top Motown hits.
Yeah, so here's our new project. We found this really good playlist on Spotify, the top 100 Motown hits.
Yep.
And we would like to do all of the songs on that playlist, which is 100.
My idea was that do one song of that playlist for 1 year. So that's 52 songs of the 100. So which songs will make it to the list.
Next episode is this Friday and we're gonna conclude our celebration episode, our 60 episode celebration with a classic Danni Tjokko medley.
That's right.
This medley for all our friends on Koh Phangan, they will know this one, right? Do it.
Do it.
Do it.
All right. Thank you.
now. We come to fun to keep up who we are. Let's raise the bar and our cups to the stars. She's up all night to get some. She's up all night to get some. She's up all night for good fun. She's up all night to get lucky. Nothing but babble, so let's do it like we do on the Discovery Channel.
I'm up all night to get lucky. Are you up all night to get lucky?
I'm up all night because I get lucky.
Oh.
How did you like that one, huh?
That's Danni Tjokko classic Get Lucky medley.
Amen. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you for watching all 60 if you have. Thank you for watching in general if you didn't watch all 60. That doesn't matter. And
yeah, I'm going to say what matters the most is that we did something.
Yeah.
And we were doing it for us. I mean, we can look at this. You know, Willow can look at this, you know, 10 years from now and like, crazy parents or whatever.
Yeah.
This will be great memories. I mean, this will probably be the best memories that we have from Pittsburgh. I mean, we were occupied.
That's true. We were keeping busy and we were having fun while doing it too.
Yeah.
Exactly.
And keeping our mind sane and...
Yeah, in the membrane.
Yeah.
So here's the 60 more. To me.
Yeah.
At least until the Motown playlist is completely done. We'll see you on Friday.
Okay. Bye for now.
Bye for now.